This is Deepa Bachu. She is one of our Indian development leaders in our Indian Development Center in Bangalore. When we challenged our Indian organization to invent the new businesses to change the financial lives of Indians, she and a small team decided to look at farmers, because farmers are about 65% of Indian households, and they're poor. They went out, she led the effort, into the farms, fields, villages, into the marketplaces where they sell their goods, to try to find where was that important unsolved problem that we could solve. And they thought they found one in the marketplaces. Because when the farmers harvest their goods, they have to take them for sale to wholesalers. They have a choice. The farmer can go to the village to the north, where the wholesalers are, or to another village to the south, where a different set of wholesalers are, or to the east. And farmers don't have a clue where to go. No data. They don't know where the best price is going to be. And once they get there, they don't know what the best price is. So the team's hypothesis was that if we could actually get the price data that day from the various markets, north, south, east, and feed it on a cheap cell phone, which all the farmers have, the farmer would know where to go take their goods, and when they got there, they'd have a basis for negotiation. So the net benefit would be they'd get higher prices for their goods, which is pure profit into their pocket. Well, there were lots of reasons to believe this wouldn't work. Like, the farmers are often illiterate. Would they trust this data? Would they act on it? If they went to a different market, how would the farmer even know what the price delta was, since the farmer didn't that day go to the original market? So would they believe they'd gotten any benefit from the system? Could we even get the price information? Would the wholesalers give it to us if the wholesalers thought it would shift demand away? So there were lots of reasons to believe this wouldn't work. And the hierarchy in our global division didn't like the idea. In fact, over the course of this project, they tried to kill it twice. They worked for me. Our management team tried to kill it twice. But because our teams have freedom to experiment, which was just starting at the time that Deepa led this, the team was allowed to experiment. They ran an experiment. They got 120 farmers. They did it. The team built no software, did the whole thing by hand. 14 wholesalers. At the end of the experiment, 80% of the farmers said they saved money, and they said that made more money. The average increase, they claimed, was 15% in the price they got. Our going-in hypothesis was 10%. So this was 50% better than we'd expected. Well, the team continued to experiment and continued to experiment. And now, 2 years later, we have a service called Fasal, which in Hindi means harvest. And we have over 900,000 farmers who use it. They get their farm price information on it. They use it at time of harvest. And they report now 16% higher prices, which translates into take-home pay of a 20% increase in their take-home income. This is an instant anti-poverty program. It's all for free to the farmers, and it's a business for us. Though we're not profitable today, we've now proven that advertising works, and these farmers really do pay attention to the messages and to the ads that come along with them. All because this team was allowed to experiment.